Good afternoon and happy Thanksgiving to you. It's so great to be with you. A warm Ardmore welcome to you. Blessings on your Thanksgiving day. And thanks for taking a moment to join with your church family as we come together to worship God, to say thanks to God on this day. Would you join me in an opening prayer? Let us pray. Loving God, thank you for your grace and your mercy and your love. And on this day, a day of thankfulness, God, we say thank you for all the good gifts, the gift of life, the gift of love, the gift of sharing together. God, would you bless this day as we reflect? It's in your name that we pray. Amen.
God's steadfast love endures. We pray for your loving purpose in every life this day and in the days to come.
And God's faithfulness to all generations. Amen.
Our scripture reading for this Thanksgiving Day comes from Luke, the 17th chapter. Hear now the word of the Lord. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." As they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to the God except this foreigner?" Then he said to them, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God.
This afternoon, we're going to share together in Holy Communion. So I invite you, wherever you are, if you have some bread and some juice at home, you can participate as well. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and before one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. This proves God's love for us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. By your appointment, the seasons come and go. You bring forth bread from the earth and create the fruit of the vine. You formed us in your image and made us stewards of your world. Earth has yielded its treasure, and from your hand we have received blessing on blessing. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Though he was rich, yet for our sake he became poor. When hungry and tempted, he refused to make bread for himself, that he might be the bread of life for others. When the multitudes were hungry, he fed them. He broke bread with the outcast, but drove the greedy from the temple. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, God, you gave birth to your church. Delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us. He took bread and he gave thanks. He broke the bread and he gave that bread to his disciples. And he said to them, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When that same supper, when it was over, he took the cup and he gave thanks to God for it. And then he gave it to his disciples. And he said to them, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these mighty acts that are done in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and a living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Because there is one loaf, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ, and the cup over which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. So that, brothers and sisters, God invites all to his table. I invite you to partake in Holy Communion where you are, by whatever means that you are able. The body of Christ broken for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Would you pray with me? Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
one righteous, not one who understands. There is one who seeks God, no, not one. I see no, not one. So I am thankful that I've been capable of doing any good on my own. We're all stillborn, dead in our transgressions, shackled up to the sin hold so dear. So what part can I play in the work of my redemption? I can't refuse, I cannot add a thing. 'Cause I am just like Lazarus, I can hear your voice. I stand and rub my eyes and walk to you. I have no choice, so I am thankful that I'm capable of doing any good on my own. Yes, I am thankful that I'm capable of doing any good on my own. By grace I have been saved, faith is not my own. It is the gift of God and not by works, lest anyone should boast. I am thankful, I'm incapable of doing any good on my own. I said I'm so thankful that I'm incapable.
Thanks for sharing your Thanksgiving Day with us. We're thankful for you. And know that God loves you and cares so deeply about you. And God's presence is with you wherever you are. So this day, thank you. Thanks to Jerry and to the choir and to Matthew and to Meredith so that we could have a moment to share together. May you be reminded of God's eternal love for you. A love that cannot be earned. A love that there's nothing that you can do to miss out on that. All we do is we come to God and we say, God, thank you for your love and your grace and your mercy. So blessings to you. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.